pray in thanksgiving for all that we have accomplished and for the grace to do what remains to be done in bring about peace and justice in our own country and around the world. God our Father, giver of life, we entrust the United States of America to your loving care. You are the rock on which this nation was founded. You alone are the true source of our cherished rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Reclaim this land for your glory and dwell among your people. Send your spirit to touch the hearts of our nation's leaders. Open their minds to the great worth of human life and the responsibilities that accompany human freedom. Remind your people that true happiness is rooted in seeking and doing your will. Through the intercession of Mary Immaculate, patroness of our land, grant us the courage to retread the culture of death. Lead us into a new millennium of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
As we raise our country's flag. As we raise our flag, we honor the red for valor, the white for purity, blue for justice, and the stars for dreams. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Maybe going to church every day feels weird, but I still make an effort to do my part. It's still like a normal school, but with some other benefits, like going to church on Friday and Sunday, and the Eucharist and Catholic Schools Week. I like the school, the faculty, staff, and teachers and students. It's a great school. And it's not just the school, it's the church too. I like hearing the choir sing, the prayers, and the people a part of the church. In my opinion, I think this is great. Sure, it might have its ups and downs, but it's still a good school. I think being non-Catholic and going to a school, a Catholic school, is not that bad until you get used to it. Thank you.
Aww. Put your hands together for Ashley. We'll now have sixth grade.
Good morning, faculty, staff, teachers, and students. I am Aaliyah Smart Paul, and I'm a Christian in a Catholic school. As a Christian, I think it's a privilege to be in a Catholic school. Since I came to the school, I've been improving in my personality and knowledge. The point of a Catholic school is to develop children by teaching the nourishing and nourishing them physically, mentally, socially, and spiritually. When I first got here, I thought that since I'm a Christian, I can't be in a Catholic school. But I realized I didn't have to be Catholic to be in a Catholic school. I have to believe in God, and that's how I'm very lucky to be in this school. I'd like to thank Ms. Barris for accepting me at St. Helen. I also want to thank Sister for teaching me and delivering the Lord's message. Thank you.
Woo! Put your hands together for Aaliyah. We will now have a seventh grade.
Good morning, students, teachers, faculty, and staff. As some may or may not know, I'm not Catholic. I'm a United Methodist Christian. And I'd like to talk about my experience partly getting to know what it's like to be a part of the Catholic Church. As a United Methodist, I still do believe in God the Father, Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And in my opinion, for the most part, all Christians' objective are the same: to celebrate the life of Jesus Christ, get baptized, and live an obedient life to God's words and teachings until our salvation. With that being said, there are many activities in Catholicism that I'm not familiar with, such as going to church on Friday and being surrounded by people who believe in Jesus. There are many examples, but one of the most important is praying rosary. I pray rosary with my peers because I'm obligated to. But the thing with that is, you can start off praying the rosary as a non-Catholic, but the more you pray, you won't stay that way for long. That's because of how efficient praying rosary is in converting our hearts. As I say all this, I know one thing is certain. If I didn't believe in Jesus Christ already, I would be Catholic. I've just recently started to fathom how persuasive the Catholic faith is, how it could be the reason for how diverse the religion is. There are Catholic men and women all across the earth. That's one positive aspect, because Christ saves everyone. Thank you.
Woo! Put your hands together for Bernie. Good job, guys. We will now have eighth grade. Put your hands together for her.
Good morning, everyone. Ms. Barrett, Father Lucien, students and teachers. You might know me from around the school, but if you don't, my name is Janai Bename, and I've been going to the school since pre-K. I've seen this school change and grow for years, and I'm going to be talking about my time at St. Helen as a non-Catholic and as a Seventh-day Adventist. If you want to be specific about how long I've been here, I've been going to St. Helen since pre-K, so a decade. I turned 14 last September, so that just puts a lot of things in perspective for me. One thing I will say about being at St. Helen for all this time is that I never felt different from my peers once, and I think it's that close-knitted community that makes our school stand apart. In fact, I've been going here for so long that I'm a bit unprepared for high school. I think it's because St. Helen is a relatively small school compared to other schools, that once I leave this bubble, I won't know what to expect. What I do know is that St. Helen has played a major part in who I am now and my future going forward. I think I learned a lot educationally and in terms of my character. Don't get me wrong, there were times where I was tired of ironing my uniform and I begged my parents to put me in a public school. But if I'm being honest, I'm really glad they didn't, because imagine where I'd be. Exactly. I can't imagine going to any other Catholic school but St. Helen. Thank you.
Your hands together for her.
Good morning, everyone. How are you? Good morning, everyone. How are you? Awesome. I started my journey here at St. Helen even before I started working here. I remember coming here and, you know, getting involved in activities and events and everything. At one point, when my little one, a little bit younger, I even tried getting her into St. Helen. So that's how long I've been on this journey with St. Helen. However, God had his own plans, and he decided that, listen, this is where I want you. And years after, you know, just being in and out, he officially placed me here. And one thing I can say for certain, I am not just here as a teacher. I am a mom. I'm a counselor. I'm at everything in this school. And I'm so happy that I'm able to wear all these different hats, because we all need that mom outside of that teacher. We all need that counselor outside of being that teacher. So I'm happy for those who I've left a mark or an imprint on. I'm happy that I was able, or God has given me that zeal that I can leave my mark on you. And the journey is just begun. The journey has just begun. We have a long, long way to go. But with hard work and determination, and with the help of you, you know, your parents, our staff, we're going to make it, guys. You know, we just, the sky's the limit, and we just got to be positive and have an open mind about everything going forward. Thank you.
Put your hands together for Ms. Walker. Father Lucien.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
How are you? I just want to say good morning and happy Catholic School Week. I said yesterday what I had to say. I said, well, I said enough for you. If you were there yesterday at Mass, I think I have said a lot. I have said enough. And once again, happy Catholic School Week. And I am a product of the Catholic education. And I thank God for that. I thank my parents, I thank the church, I thank the religious community I started with. And I thank all my teachers. Eh? Teachers, I love my teachers, and learn how to love your teachers. Eh? Learn how to love your teacher, learn how to respect them, and to listen and obey them. So they want the best for you, and as each and every one of us, each and every one of them, want you to succeed, to become a good citizen, good Christian, good Catholic. So, and once again, God bless each and every one of you and your family, your loved one. God bless.
Thank you, Father. We will now have Mrs. Barrett with the closing remarks. Put your hands together for Mrs. Barrett.
Good morning, St. Helen Spartans.
Good morning, Ms. Barrett, and may the Lord be with you.
I want to take this opportunity to first thank Sister Fawn for all her hard work, for planning this ceremony and all the activities to come this week to celebrate Catholic Schools Week. I also want to thank our student speakers in sharing their experience with us in Catholic schools. Janaya said it perfectly. St. Helen has created a bubble for you guys to feel safe and loved. I hope that you find this bubble your home, that you feel that we have prepared you not only academically, but more importantly, that we have helped you to develop character, because that is going to take you far and beyond just your education. As Janaya said, I have a special place in my heart for St. Helen Catholic School. As a high school student myself, I volunteered at St. Helen Catholic School for well over 10 years as a CCD teacher who started off as an assistant, and then I had my own class. I substituted while I was working on my degree to become a teacher. I taught here before becoming an administrator. Eighth graders, middle schoolers, take this as a chance to come back to your community, to offer the safety and welcoming that you felt while you were here to other students. Giving back to your community is what being a Catholic Christian person is. You take care and you bless those around you because you are truly blessed. I am truly blessed to have served as your administrator, as your teacher, as your mentor. I'm truly blessed to have teachers who share in my vision in building character and making sure that you grow academically so that you can achieve whatever God's will is for your life. It makes my heart very happy to hear about our non-Catholics speaking about their relationship with God. That is first and foremost the most important thing that we want you to learn here is to build your relationship with God, to follow His will for your life, and there is nothing that you cannot do if you are following in that path. So again, thank you, sister, for all the events that you have planned for this week. Thank you, students, for being St. Helen Spartans. And thank you, staff, for being a part of the vision that we have for our children. Thank you, and thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Barrett. I'm going to ask everyone to stand as we sing our closing song. It is on the other side of your song sheet, This Little Light of Mine. Come on, guys, sing.